Thank you, Your Honor. May it please the court, Kyle Wilson for Plaintiff Appellant Amber Machowski. The ADA was enacted into law in order to fully protect and allow participation in society for our nation's most vulnerable citizens. However, in order for the ADA to achieve this goal, it relies on private enforcement. In turn, effective private enforcement requires fair and reasonable awards of attorney's fees. In this case, the district court simply did not do that. The court ignored the established law, which the Supreme Court has long held that the lodestar method is presumptively reasonable approach to determining an appropriate award of fees.
Counsel, with respect, I'm looking primarily at the Vogel case, which of course our court decided. And if I'm construing that correctly, what the case says is that if you don't like the default amount, then you need to move the district court to consider lodestar, and then the district court has to do that. My understanding is you didn't do that. Now, the district court acted preemptively, but you didn't ask for a motion for reconsideration or anything. Have you not waived the issue under Vogel?
Your Honor, I think that I agree that we did not move for relief at the district court level, but I think the issue comes down to the fact that under Purdue versus Kenny A. X. Rel. Wynn, which is a Supreme Court case decided in 2010, that the lodestar approach is the presumptively reasonable approach.
So how do you overcome the presumption that in this case, as you know, this language, the default judgment that and for the district court been there forever, for a long time, and the district court, you said you were going to move for attorney fees. The district court acted before that happened, but you didn't say, "Hey, wait a minute, Your Honor, you made a mistake. We want to ask for this, and we want lodestar consideration." That's what I'm struggling with. I mean, I don't question the public policy issues. I don't question that if you ask for lodestar consideration, you're entitled to it under Vogel, but I don't see why this isn't a waiver.
Well, I think the issue comes down to the fact that Local Rule 55-3 effectively reverses the presumption established by the Supreme Court, and it establishes the percentage schedule under 55-3 as a presumptive approach and makes it so that the lodestar approach is the alternative. And that, in effect, entails more work for the plaintiff and more judicial resources to be consumed by every time in a civil rights case if the court is going to apply the 55-3 and then the plaintiff has to come back and argue about applying the lodestar method. Is creating inefficiencies and unnecessary consumption of judicial resources when the presumption should be to from the first instance that the lodestar method should be applied.
Well, you're ignoring Vogel, are you not? You think that the Supreme Court case that you cite controls it, but that at most is a presumption. It's not a requirement. Vogel says what you need to do, you didn't do it, right?
Well, I don't think Vogel requires the...
It requires, if you want lodestar, you've got to say so.
That's not my interpretation of it. My interpretation of it is that that was the facts of the case, and that in that case and how it was decided was based on the fact that in Vogel, the plaintiff did ask for it to be considered under lodestar, and the district court denied that request or didn't do it appropriately. But I don't think Vogel says that you have to do that. I don't think Vogel stands for
if you want to assure yourself you're going to get lodestar treatment, that's what you do, right?
Well, I mean, I don't think that's what Vogel says. I don't think Vogel says that you have to do it that way. And I think to the extent that 55-3 reverses the presumption established under the Supreme Court that the lodestar method is the presumption of reasonableness, I think it's creating these unnecessary hoops for plaintiffs to have to jump through.
But with respect, counsel, again, you're the expert in this. My understanding is that almost all of the cases that you bring, you don't even get a response. You pick a mom and pop shop, you get them for an ADA violation, you ask for some money, they agree to pay some money or to settle, you then ask for attorney fees. And, you know, nobody even responds. But if you're going to get Lodestar, you've got to provide information so the court can make a determination based upon the information you provide. There's no extra work involved there. None at all. You have to provide that information if you want Lodestar, right?
Well, the other issue, too, is that Local Rule 55-3 says that the application has to be made at the time of the entry of judgment for any deviation from 55-3. And, you know, it takes time to prepare a statement of billing and to submit the request for attorney's fees.
You're asking for Lodestar, and Lodestar, by definition, involves you're providing that information so the court can make a determination, right?
Right, right. I understand that. I think, Your Honor, the issue is also with timing under Local Rule 55-3, and that it requires it to be made at the time of the entry of judgment. And in this case, you know, they didn't give us the time to prepare to be able to present the...
Okay, but we, as we discussed before, all you needed to do was to file a motion for reconsideration. Say, hey, look, you went ahead, you didn't even wait for us. We said we're going to file a motion. We want, under Vogel, we want Lodestar. Here's our information. And the court would undoubtedly have said, okay, well, you're right.
Well, so that motion is itself extra work, though, and that creates judicial inefficiency. So it's not just applying for the Lodestar. It's also the work of writing a motion and submitting a motion and potentially having to reach out to try and meet and confer on that motion with a defendant who's not present. So, I mean, there is more work involved when you don't have the initial presumption of the Lodestar and instead go with the presumption of 55-3.
That's your best argument?
That is my best argument.
Okay.
So I submit. Thank you, Your Honor.
Any other questions that my colleagues have? Very well. Thank you. It's unusual to have one lawyer appear in a case, but we thank you for your argument, and the case just argued is submitted, and we thank you. Have a good day.
Thank you, Your Honor. You too.